All in favor? Aye, carry. Close. Administrator.
Student council is not here tonight, and I don't believe she brought us her report. So we'll go forward. The graduation is tomorrow night, and we have 103 graduates. Are you all going to be able to come, do you think? If you can come, we would love to have you come. It is tomorrow night. Pictures are taken ahead of time this year, so we told the kids they need to be there at 6:30. We'll be there at 6. Be there to get on that stage. And we have practice, and I think, as I told you earlier, take good thoughts because as of right now, there's not one there. The summer moving plan, we have a lot of people that are moving themselves. Right now, we have a lot of classrooms that have moved. The staff is working together exceptionally, I mean, just phenomenal, as always, to get themselves moved over to Corkman and then to get people moved in. We are going to have some extra furniture. Actually, Mrs. Ralston is still helping us with that, and we're doing our best. Right now, it looks like we may have 2 to 3 empty classrooms at Corkman, but we're probably going to go ahead and furnish those. It comes up, I think, a little further in the enrollment. The enrollment right now, I believe, is 1102, and it's gone up 60 in just recently. So we're anticipating, I don't know where they're coming from, but they're coming in. The staffing plan that you have in front of you, it moves 2 teachers down. It moves Shelly Dickerson to first grade and moves Barbara Poyer to first grade. It's contingent on further decisions tonight for teachers. You can see that there will be 52 teaching positions. First grade will go from 5 to 7. So first grade, for class size reduction, first grade must be fully implemented and cannot run over. You can have an overflow class in kindergarten, second, or third grade. You cannot have an overflow class in first grade. They must run 20 or below. And I believe, my memory's right, with the 7 classes, they're running about 18, which gives us about 14 spots. So that's what we're looking at tentatively right now as a staffing plan. You also have a letter from the City of El Centro from the housing element language. Tom Buddy and Arnold Preciado and myself, we met with them. And this is what we've been working toward, that the housing element that the city plan would actually address, as it says here in Concept 1, coordinated growth, infrastructure, funding, and coordinated use and joint use. We're not asking the city to go above and beyond SB 50. What we're asking is, though, that the schools be part of their annual plan of planned growth. And it was a really good meeting. It's a pleasure working with Norma Villacana, and we have submitted this language, and we went over this language with them in person, and we've now submitted this language formally from the school districts to go into the housing element. At this point, I don't have a reason to think that if most of it, if not all of it, won't be included, but it does have to go through their policies and procedures and checks and balances. So that's a letter for you to have to be able to see at this time. The projected enrollment, what you have in front of you is 1,100, and I believe there's something on my desk that says 1,102. And it's just kind of continuing to climb back and forth. And, you know, I think the thing that they were the most appreciative is we brought them language. There was no, you know, no having to go out and reinvent the wheel. We went through the housing element and gave them specific places that this would fit into, and I felt they were very receptive to it. I thought it went very well. And there's nothing controversial in there. It's just that if you're going to look, if a developer is going to look at fire and police, to put, he's going to look at schools at the same time.
Anything else on the courts?
No.
Consent and A and B, the regular board meeting minutes.
We need to make a change here.
And the warrants for the month of May.
Motion to approve.
Mike? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carries 5-0. Item 7, business. A, discuss approved purchase agreement for the Linda Business School site. You talked to Amanda, you come up with some other things. I mean, bottom line, the board still would like to go through the purchase agreement at what we talked about before. $800,000 cash, $250 tax. We're not receptive to the time frame for non-development or the impact of the change.
No, it's just a few points that we wanted to talk through with you guys. We got the agreement from your attorney about a day before the last board meeting. It's too bad we lost all this time, but just a few things, and we've made some good headway on some of them. I know you guys were concerned about the ag pipeline that was going to go along the east side and the north side. And we've been working with the city engineer on that. And it looks like we're going to be able to redesign that, where we'll just take that pipeline along the south side of your school site and then north, so it'll be in the roads that Linda Vista's building and not the ones that affect your school. So that's going to be good, I think, and simplify things. And regarding the street lights, you guys were asking the city to be a party to our agreement to limit your exposure to building streets. So I've done some research on that, and the one on your east side is called Cypress Street, and that's going to be 40 feet of asphalt from curb to curb, and I went out there and measured it, and 32 is already built. So the most you guys could have to build there is 8 feet more of asphalt. And then on the north side is Valley View, and that's going to be 64 feet of asphalt, and 32 is already there. So that'll be exactly half. So what I think we should do on those two points, instead of having the city attorney review our entire 15-page contract, would be to do a separate agreement on those points so we can streamline